When I think of open-mindedness, I think of diversity as well as accepting people and things for what they are, for who they are and what they are.
Being more liberal than conservative. It's always having an open mind to everything, giving anything and everything a try. I think the being open-minded is how I got through college.
I automatically think of trying new things and being open and accepting of new things that are out of the norm or out of my culture.
I think of someone that's not closed off to new experiences that will broaden their horizons.
I tend to think about being well-rounded, having experiences in multiple genres of music and art and education, just based upon it being open-minded, being well-rounded, and having knowledge, lack of ignorance.
To me, different types of music all have similar elements, and they're all forms of storytelling, so they're all valid voices. And for me, different music shows me different ways that different cultures and people tell stories and show how things are important to them.
Every American genre of music started with African Americans. You can even take jazz in New Orleans. That was basically classical music. Classical instruments like trumpets and saxophones and clarinets being used to play funky music, you know, changing it up, doing exactly what you want to do with it. And same with blues. Blues is like folk music, folk guitar, but it's basically the story of a black man who's poor in the South. This is the blues that I have. And the same with rock and roll. Like, rock and roll came about when Chuck Berry started playing blues really fast on the guitar, or when Little Richard started playing blues really fast on the piano. And then from that, you know, at the time, like, after the popularity of rock and roll, you had, it was marketable. So a lot of times what would happen was white artists would be called rock and roll artists, and then they would classify the rock and roll artists that were black as rhythm and blues. And from that vein, rhythm and blues became an exclusively black genre of music. And from that, you have cats like James Brown, who really did lay the format for what a hip-hop beat is.
I listen to a variety of music. I listen to R&B and hip-hop. I listen to a little bit of pop, some alternative music. Some people don't know that about me. But in particular for R&B music, I listen to a lot of old school music, a lot of Teddy Pendergrass, a lot of Marvin Gaye. But I just listen to a lot of different musical artists.
I like it all. Like pop by Selena Gomez. Not a lot of people listen to Selena Gomez, but I like her. And I listen to rap, hip-hop, pop, country. Anything that speaks to me. It's not all about who the artist is or what everybody is into. I like what speaks to me.
Musical tastes. Well, my musical tastes are very, very, very open-minded. And I say that now. I haven't always been that way, but I've been that way for a very long time. Since I started making music, I actually studied the art of music, not just the type of music I want to make. I study music in general. So what I do now to make sure that mine is completely original and just like from my heart, I touch bases with a lot of things. Like I try to learn as much as I can. So I'll listen to a alternative rock song or a pop song, and I'll go study early hip hop or today's hip hop or R&B or jazz or soul music. So when I'm creating my music, I have all those influences and I can touch broader bases.
So I know it sounds really trite, but I do listen to everything. I have, my roots are in punk and hardcore music, But, you know, I literally listen to everything from banjo music to Tchaikovsky. I really get into a lot of political hip-hop. Sage Francis is one of my favorites. Dead Prez, stuff like that. I mean, I was raised in a household that, you know, everybody had a different kind of musical style. And I won't ever say, oh, I don't like, you know, one kind of music, because there are some, like old country. I like old Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson. I like, you know, even stuff like, you know, some Britney Spears songs, things like that, that, you know, some of my punk friends would be like, what's wrong with you? You know, you're listening to Christina Aguilera. And I'm like, yeah, you know, I like it. It's just, sometimes it's just fun, and other times it has a message that I like. It just really depends on my mood and, you know, what's handed to me.
Okay, so you're probably going to think this is kind of random and off the wall for me, but this is what I mean by people just assuming that just because you look a certain way or come from a certain place that you do certain things. And since I was a little girl, I at least elementary school, I remember listening to pop music or what they consider white music. I never listened to country music, but I do like those types of genres, along with hip-hop and R&B.
I'm down to listen to different things. You know, when I was younger, like, you know, coming from an urban area, you know, they try to, you know, stereotype you if you didn't listen to hip-hop, so I try to make it seem like I knew everything about hip-hop and rap and R&B when, you know, secretly I love pop music. Like, I like this group called Dream. I don't know if anyone remembers that. They used to be with Bad Boys. I kind of like Mandy Moore a little bit, and Joy Enriquez. But, you know, with me, I try everything when it comes to music once. Like, I listen to hard rock. I just don't like it. It's too loud and it gives me a headache. But I do like some punk groups like Fall Out Boy and Good Charlotte. And, you know, I listen to rap. I don't like all rap. I'm still more of a pop and R&B person, though.
I'm pro musical experimentation. However, I think a lot of people don't understand the power of music. Music has the power to make you feel all different types of feelings. I know you listen to certain songs when you're sad, when you're in a relationship, you listen to different music than when you just broke up with somebody. You listen to different music when you're feeling spiritual, rather you're feeling, you know, in a party mood. Music has a way of making you feel what it feels. So, I definitely feel that if I were to listen to something I've never listened to before, I would have to not necessarily research it, but have some type of idea of how it could possibly make me feel. Like, alternative music, when it comes to it, there's certain stuff I will not listen to because it just makes me feel gloomy. It makes me feel sad. But I do enjoy, like, Green Day and stuff of that nature because it's more uplifting, more upbeat versus, oh, and I like corn too, but versus some, you know, R&B artists and some hip-hop artists that just make me feel violent, you know? You gotta be careful what you listen to.
I am not opposed to trying different types of music. I mean, if I was opposed to trying different types of music, I don't think I would have ever discovered reggae, which turned out to be the passion and the love of my life because I really, really love the music. It's inspirational, it's motivating, it's a lot of things. So, you know, I find that being open to other types of music, other experiences, just helps you see the world differently. You kind of understand where people are coming from. So I'm totally open to just listening to other genres of music, from African music to jazz to classical, whatever, because great music tells a story and you can connect with it.
I'm not opposed to trying different types of music because a lot of the R&B and hip-hop is real sexual. And they bring people down. It's not really talk about nothing. You think about it, they all talk about is sex, money, and getting high. But people with pop and country and all the other genres, I don't really listen to rock, but I'm pretty sure they have messages. Like, they speak about love, real love, and situations that they go through. They don't really talk about, well, I'm not saying they don't talk about sex, but they don't really focus on it like all the other genres of music do.
No, I'm not opposed to listening to new music. Like, I love to listen to reggae. I don't understand everything that they're saying in reggae, but I'll listen to it. I don't understand some of these Katy Perry and some other pop songs, you know, what the point of those are, but, you know, I'll listen to it just so I can get a feel for what people are listening to and what is hot right now on the radio. I mean, you know, I have to expand my horizon, and the only way to do that is to step outside the box in my comfort zone.
Not opposed to trying new music. Very open to it. And I guess I'm open to it because that's just the type of person I am. I would never want to just close out something without giving it a try. Especially when music is an art and somebody's creation. Like, these are their creative thoughts. And you never want to just shoot down somebody's ideas, especially if it's a passion that they've worked so hard for and they believe in. Like, you, I mean, what kind of person would I be to just shoot somebody's music down just because I don't want to listen on my ignorant behalf?
And if it come down to it, he can scrap. Hate it. Here come Big Will again.
Here I come, y'all. Here I come.
It's sad to say, but the campus that I am on is North Carolina Central University. And a lot of the students are on the same level mentally when it comes to music. Me being experienced and bringing artists to campus, if I have Nat King Cole's album that I had to redo, no one's interested in going to the opening for that. But if I brought Jeezy or Plies or somebody, it's like the whole campus will come out to something like that. But it's sad that everybody's kind of stuck in the same block mentally. I wish everybody was open-minded to receive different type of music styles, because we could actually bring a lot to this campus, not just hip-hop acts.
I feel like overall that a majority of the students would only be willing to listen to hip-hop and R&B. But there are students out here that are open-minded, and particularly females. I think females listen to more music than guys do. But I think a majority of the students would limit themselves to hip-hop and R&B. But there are those out here that will venture out and listen to a little bit of this, a little bit of that, you know. I think it's important to expand your horizon. So I'm one of the few that will listen to music other than hip hop and R&B.
I put music on AudioNet all the time that would be considered pop, some reggae, you know, but I throw in pop stuff. So like when Hannah Montana, what's her name, Miley Cyrus, when she did, what's the song, Party in the USA, I put that on the system here, and people would walk in the room and start singing Party in the USA. I have Selena Gomez on Love You Like a Love Song, which, you know, you only hear like on Disney, and everybody comes through and they're like, I like that song, I like that, you know. So they're definitely open to hearing different things. When I first came to the university, we actually had a rock show on AudioNet, and I've had students in the past say, hey, can we do this? Well, if you have the music and you're interested and you want to do it, I'm down for it. You heard it here first.
I do think the majority population at North Carolina Central University would be open to experiences of music beyond rap, hip-hop, and R&B. I do think that as a culture, as an African-American culture and as an HBCU, we tend to sometimes put ourselves in a box in terms of, I don't think, you know, the rest of my black friends would like this music because it's not hip-hop and R&B, but at the same time, you like it. I know I have a lot of friends that I didn't know listened to country, you know, or listened to rock, and all different types of musical forms, you know. But it took me, you know, being open-minded about other people, you know, to realize that there are other people that like different things just like I do. Even though they still may like hip-hop and R&B and rap, they're open to other musical experiences, and especially, and I think, in a college setting, in this day and age when we're in an increasingly global society, more people will gravitate to more musical expressions, you know, just because it's in their view more often.
No, I think NCCU students are not open to trying different music simply because, like I stated earlier, music involves your feelings. It makes you feel a certain way. It gives you a different mindset of what you would normally have based upon what you're listening to. Like, for instance, I know when a lot of guys are in their cars, they want to listen to, you know, riding music, stuff, you know, get them excited, get them hyped, keep them entertained. However, you can't do that with other genres. Like, you can't do that listening to Selena Gomez or Justin Bieber. Therefore, they're going to not listen to those types of artists, those types of music, because it's not going to put them in that same mindset. And with us being African Americans and the publicity that's so forced upon us with being, you know, with money, cars, clothes, fame, and fashion, you're going to listen to music that exemplifies that and not into stuff that's going to humble you and make you charitable and giving. A lot of that comes from hip-hop. Now, there's nothing wrong with hip-hop. Hip-hop is okay, but to a certain degree, when it brainwashes you to think inside this box, there's a problem.
I mean, it's hard to say because you got to put the shoe on the other foot, too. Would UNC be open to other things besides punk and rock? I mean, it's more of a demographic thing more so than an individual thing. I mean, overall, more of the students have grown up listening to a certain genre, because if you go to poll DC students, depending on where you're from, they would want to listen to go-go before they want to listen to some hip-hop artists. So I think it's more so the demographic of who you're trying to reach more so than the students as an overall, you know, population. Because I know a lot of my friends who would rather go to UNC and go to their clubs versus going to, like, Rumba, that's what it was called when I was here, but like rather go to Rumba than that. So I would say overall more students would rather listen to hip-hop and R&B, but I mean, it's the surroundings is where we're from, that's what we're grown up to be accustomed to.
I think the majority of them wouldn't necessarily be open to it, like as open to it, but I do know there are several people, like, since I began studying music on NCCU's campus, I do know there are several people who enjoy all the time. Like, the whole music department is, nobody does R&B or rap, and then the whole music department is jazz and different things like that. And since I've been a part of it, I've actually began to enjoy those things more.
I think in years past, maybe NCCU's general population would not be accepting of other genres beyond R&B and hip-hop. But I think recently, with the attention given to enhancing the intellectual climate of our campus, I think that students are beginning to become open-minded in a variety of areas, not only in the musical stylings offered by the university. And I think other avenues that are supported by our university, such as AudioNet, they attempt to reach outside of the box of what is comfortable for our university students.
I believe it can happen. I believe if the music department starts to spread out and people become more aware, they'll love it. Like, we have jazz concerts. I performed in one the other day, and I'm not a jazz musician by any means, but I sung a jazz song. It was cool, and I enjoyed it. I think if more people showed up to that, the way they show up to the fashion show, they'd love it. So, yeah, I mean, I don't think so at this point, but I think it's possible.
Because, you know, of course, we have the coffee shops and get-together types of things. Well, at least they did when I was here in undergrad in the Union, where, you know, people would come and do spoken word and soulful music. It wouldn't be a huge crowd, but it would be a good chunk. And that's alternative compared to what you think the norm is. So who knows? Maybe they just need that nudge.
So I think, yes, minds are opening up. So maybe in years to come, we will actually see that.
It's all the same vein. Like, even though we look at these different genres as different, or I guess it's almost like a different type of person has to listen to this, this, and this. No, it's all coming from the same human vein. Party rock! Party rock!
party rockers in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time.
Yeah.
And we gon' make you lose your mind.
Woo.
Everybody just have a good time.
Clap.
Party rockers in the house tonight.